Hello everyone, you're welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to project the VerseVIEW software from your secondary PC to your vMix PC, as you can see right here on the screen. So I have two PC currently on this table, and one of them, which is the secondary PC, is dedicated for the VerseVIEW software, and my primary PC is dedicated for the vMix software. And I'm able to project the Bible from the VerseVIEW software all the way down to the vMix software, and whatever changes I'm making from the VerseVIEW software, I'll just show you that real quick so that you can see it. Whatever changes I'm making from the VerseVIEW software is also reflecting on the vMix software, and it doesn't take time, just ASAP. It's very fast, and this is what I'm going to show you in today's video. If you're just coming across the channel for the first time, smash that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I upload videos like this on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, just do me a favor, smash that like button if you love the video so the YouTube algorithm can also recommend this to other people on the YouTube community that would want to be part of our little family here on this channel. Without any further ado, let's jump right into the tutorial. Now, the first thing you are going to do is to go ahead and install VerseVIEW on your PC, which I've also done a video on how you can be able to set up the VerseVIEW software on your PC. Now, after you've done installing and setting up the VerseVIEW software, connect your primary PC and your secondary PC to the same Wi-Fi. Okay, so if you look back, you can see I have a network blinking right there at the back, which is where I connected both my secondary PC I use for VerseVIEW and my primary PC I also use for vMix. I connected them both on that network you see blinking right there. So the both of them are connected to it. Go ahead and open the vMix software, which is this one here I'm using here. Now, once you've opened the vMix software here, go ahead and also open the VerseVIEW software. Okay, now once you've opened the VerseVIEW software, click at the top on the VerseVIEW there, click on it, and you see the remote VerseVIEW. Okay, so the remote VerseVIEW, select the remote VerseVIEW, and you see the IP address. Now on this IP address, you're going to see two IP address. The first IP address, I've already made a video on that, is if you're using the vMix and the VerseVIEW software on the same PC. So I'll also leave a link to that particular video in the description below, how you can set up the VerseVIEW software and the vMix software on the same PC. Okay, but this one is you're using two separate PC here. So you select the first IP address. Sometimes it might be that on the second part, what does it 192 might be on the second, while the 127 might be the first. So whichever one, however it is that is arranged on your PC, make sure you select the 192, not the 127. That is the one we are making use of, okay? Because we are sending the VerseVIEW software to a second PC, which is the vMix software PC. Okay, now let's select that. Then once you're done, click on this host name here if you want. If you don't want, you can leave it, okay? But just still turn it on, okay? But if you want, you can just leave it as like that. It will still work perfectly fine. Now once you're done, enable this, okay? See the enable button there, enable that. It's very important, okay? And once you enable that, you go to the remote link here. On the remote link, you see different things here. This, the lower third, A, B, C, D, E, all those ones are if you want to display the Bible, or you want to display your song, your hymn in lower third, you can select any of the lower third. But if you want to display them on full screen, then you can use the stage view 1 or the stage view 2. Now, the stage view 1 has its own background and you can't change it. It comes with a custom background, while the stage view 2 comes with a transparent background, meaning you can give your scripture or your song a custom background to use for it. While the lower third A, B has their own custom background, but the lower third C does not have a custom background. It comes with a transparent lower third that you can also design your own custom lower third using Photoshop or the poster my wall. You can also use any of those tools to design your own custom lower third to use on it. I'm also going to show you how you can be able to bring it in on vMix. Okay, now we're going to use the stage v2, which is the transparent full screen. Okay, now once you've already done that, copy this link here, this link you see down here, just copy it and just find a way to send it to your second PC. What I'm going to do is I'm going to send it to this Facebook here. I'm going to copy it and paste it on this Facebook account here, and then go over and open it on my vMix PC. Now you come back to the vMix software, which is the one we are using for vMix. Remember, these two PC are connected to the same Wi-Fi. Okay, now I come back to the vMix. Let's open my Facebook, and you see the link right here. This is the link I just sent from the second PC, which is the one we are using for VerseVIEW. I'm just going to copy that. Let's copy it. Now once you've already copied it, let's close this. Now on the vMix, go over to the add input. Okay, so see the down below here, you see the add input there, click on the add input. So once you already open the add input, go over to web browser here, click on the web browser and paste the link that we've just copied from Facebook. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and paste the link here. And once you paste that, change the width and the height to 1920 by 1080. All right, 1920 by 1080, which is 1080. And then browser version, change it to v77. And once you already change the browser version to V, remember to use the v77 because it's smooth, right? So it will not make your production to lag when you're sending the Bible or displaying the scriptures. Okay, so once you're done, click on okay. Okay, now we've brought in the browser here and this is it. Now go ahead on the second PC that you are using for the VerseVIEW. So once you've already copied that, close this. And once you've closed it, try bringing any scripture on the screen. Just try popping any scripture and you can see this is the scripture display right here. Scripture from here all the way here. Remember that these two PC are connected to the same Wi-Fi, which is this that's blinking right there. That's the MTN Hinet. I also did a video on that. I'll leave the link in the description below as well. So you can see I'm changing the Bible here and the Bible is reflecting there. I'm changing the Bible there and it's also reflecting here. Now, how do we give it a custom background? If you want to give it a custom background, all you have to do, let me close this one here and let's also close this here. Let's close this one right here. Now just go ahead and get any video that you want to use as your background. Okay, so get any video, it can be a short video, any animation video that you want to use as a background. I'll leave a link of the ones I've compiled on my Google Drive in the description below. So this particular one I'm using is also there as well. Now get your video, bring in your video animation that you want to use, loop the video, click on the loop on vMix to loop the video. Now once you've looped the video here on the screen, go ahead and play it and you can see the way it is. This is how the video is, you can see. Now once you've already looped the video, go ahead and play it. Now once you've already played that, okay, okay, what now once you've already looped the video, click on this I can see this place on the add input at the side of it, click on it and you're going to see blank. Okay, so once you've clicked on that, you're going to see blank, or you can just right click on the add input and you're going to see blank. So whichever one you're doing, just do that and you're going to see the blank. So either you right click or you click on that dot beside it there, this dot beside it here, see this dot here beside it, or you click on the add input there, right click on the add input, put your mouse on the add input and right click and you're going to see blank. Now select the blank there, and once you've already selected the blank, what we are doing now, we are trying to create a custom background for our Bible. Okay, now if I try to project the Bible on the screen, you discover you see it's transparent. So we want to give it a custom background. Now double click on the blank template that we just created, go over to general and let's rename this Bible. Okay, Bible. Okay, so I just rename this Bible, go over to color key and tick the color key. Okay, and once you've ticked the color key, go over to layers and multi-view. On the first one, bring in the background. Okay, and on the second one, bring in the Bible. Okay, see, and this is how it's going to look like. Now if you project this on the screen, you can see how it's looking now. We've just given this Bible a custom background, and whatever changes you're making on the VerseVIEW software here, whatever changes you're making on the VerseVIEW software is also reflecting here. See, it's fast, it's up, doesn't waste time and it's really fast. Okay, so this is it. Now you can, the VerseVIEW allows you to display your both your hymn and also your Bibles as well. So if you want to learn how you can be able to get the Bible version on the VerseVIEW, or you have can add your hymn or anything, I also leave a link of that video in the description below, so go ahead and check it out so you can also learn all those things. I don't want to make this video too long. Okay, so and that is it, and you can see right there on the screen. Now if you want to change your font on VerseVIEW, all you have to do is go over on the Bible, click on Bible here on the screen. So click on the Bible and select manage version. Okay, manage version. From here you can see the font. From here you can choose any font you want to use for your Bible. You can choose any font that you want to use, maybe bold, Tahoma, whichever font you want to use. And if you want to disable this dual view here that is showing, click on this same Bible here at the top, this same Bible here, here click on it and select on, click on select a version. And from here you can disable this dual language display for navigation. So untick this dual language display, and once you're done, save and close. And you can see is looking clean, right? Let me just close this quick one. And just close this, and you can see it's looking neat right now. And whatever changes I'm making, still reflecting on our vMix software itself, as you can see right there on the screen. Now, if you want to, so if you also want to use the lower third, you don't want to use the full screen again, you want to change it to lower third, all you have to do is to click on this top here, VerseVIEW, and select remote VerseVIEW, and from here change the stage view to any of the lower third that you want to use. So lower third C, okay, so change it to lower third C, which is this one. Now once you selected that, make sure you copy this link again and get it across to your vMix PC. So just going to do that. Now open the Facebook again and paste the link here. Okay, so paste the link here, and this is it. So just get it across to your vMix PC. Now once you've done that, go back to the vMix PC that you're using, copy the link. I just sent it to the Facebook, and this is it. So I'm just going to go ahead and copy it. Now once we've copied that, let me minimize this. And this is the vMix piece. This is the template that we just brought in. If you want to add the Bible, the link that I've copied. Okay, so all you have to do is click on this add input again. Go over to web browser and paste the link that we just copied from Facebook. Now once you've pasted the link, change this to 1920 by 1080. 1920 by 1080, alright? 1080. And then browser version V77 is very important, and click on OK. Now we can make your changes from the VerseVIEW software. Okay, so you can make your changes from the VerseVIEW software, and you can see there. So this is how the lower third is looking here. You can see this is how the lower third is. Just double click on it, double click on the lower third. You see, just double click on the lower third, go over to position, and you can drag it all the way down. You can see. Can drag it all the way down. Look, it's now, it has its own transparent background there, so you can design your own custom lower third. If you want to bring it, if you want to design your own custom lower third and bring it to it, just all you have to do is to go ahead and on the add input, right click on it and select blank. Okay, I'm just going to bring my phone closer, right click on the add input and select blank. Oh, sorry, just right click on the add input here, select blank. Okay, now once you've selected blank, this is the blank template here. So double click on it, and you can give it a name. Just change the name here to whichever name you want to give it. So this color here, change the name to whichever name you want to give it, or your lower third, and go over on the color key, tick the color key, go over to layers and multi view. First, bring in the lower third, whether picture or video that you've designed for it. So just for instance, this one now. So whatever picture or video that you have for it, just bring it in. And on the second one, select the Bible here, and you can see how it is on the lower third. You can see, you just use any of the number to push it on the screen, and you can see how it is. So, and this is how it works. So whatever changes you are making from the VerseVIEW software here is going to reflect on the vMix software, but make sure that the two PC are connected to the same Wi-Fi. If not, it's not going to work. So it's very, very important. And remember to share the video if you love it, so more people can also gain from the wealth of knowledge you are sharing on this little YouTube channel.